In this video, we are going to discuss what is the global and national context of valuing diversity. The context. As we discussed, diversity is a socio-political concept of modern era. It is a value of inclusion. Concept of diversity began to receive global attention only at the end of the 20th century or only in the beginning of the 21st century. However, the diversity discussion or debate emerged in North America and Europe in early 1960s and 70s. It is linked to some of the socio-demographic changes that has happened in North America and Europe during 60s and 70s. I will discuss these details in another video. And at the end of the 20th century or the beginning of the 21st century, the diversity become one of the global concerns, and there are many transnational agencies such as United Nations, UNDP and UNESCO has done a substantial work for making diversity as a global issue or global debate. However, the Constitution of India recognized value of diversity at least a century back, even before the North America and European countries started discussing about the diversity. Thus, India's freedom movements and the Constitution clearly recognize and valorize the idea of diversity. So, I am going to discuss those things in the coming slides. The first one of the most important development in the higher education regarding diversity is UNESCO World Declaration in 1998 held in Paris. It was the beginning of right-based approach in education. By following the three generation of human rights, the civil and political rights, social, economic and cultural rights and the community rights, the UNESCO played an important role to make education as a right. So, in the conference, they have adopted a World Declaration on Higher Education for the 21st century, vision and action. So, they have detailed what should be the vision for higher education in coming century. In the preamble, the declaration says, it is convinced that education is a fundamental pillar of human rights, democracy, sustainable development and peace, and therefore education should be accessible to all throughout the life. This is one of the important dimensions and milestones in the context of education. And Article 3 of the declaration further suggests that there is a need for ensuring equity and access, and there should not be any discrimination on lines of caste, class, creed, gender, etc. All the admission or access to higher education should be based on merit, and no one should be left behind because the lack of financial capital or some other capital. But the Article 3 further suggests that there should be enough strategies to ensure access of special target groups. These special target groups are disadvantaged groups across the country. Disadvantaged groups in each country vary from country to country, but in general, the UNESCO declaration suggests we should ensure access to special target groups through various means. Most importantly, the declaration makes an important statement regarding higher education as a public service. So, it should be a public good. Therefore, it has to be distributed to needy people without any other consideration. Therefore, the declaration says the funding of higher education requires both public and private resources. However, the declaration continues, the role of the state remains essential in this regard. Although the declaration suggests need for the private and public resources, but declaration categorically states that the role of the state will remain there. So, after this UNESCO declaration, in 2001, there is a UNESCO declaration on cultural diversity. The UNESCO declaration consider cultural diversity is an extension to human rights. As we discussed in earlier, it is an extension to human rights such as civil and political rights, socio-cultural rights and community rights. And it is a source of exchange, innovation and creativity. This point we have to keep in mind. The UNESCO declaration on cultural diversity suggests that the cultural diversity is a source of exchange, innovation and creativity. It is a necessary condition, it is necessary for humanity. As we know, the humanity in essence is diverse in all forms and all means. That diversity is a major source for innovation and creativity in humankind. And it also suggests that therefore, cultural diversity is a factor in development. And finally, the declaration suggests there should be a partnership between the state, market and civil society to highlight and support cultural diversity. Next one is UNDP Human Development Report 2004. Human Development Report in 2004 focused on the cultural liberty in today's diverse world. It's very interesting to see the title of the report, The Cultural Liberty in Today's Diverse World. There is a implicit recognition that the world is too diverse compared to the earlier time and cultural diversity is important. The report suggests that and highlights that the cultural liberty is key to development. This is an important development in the context of debate on development. Why it is so? Earlier, we used to consider development as something forward looking or culture is something backward or static. Many times we consider culture is a barrier for development, barrier for the progress. However, the UNDP report in 2004 says cultural liberty is key to development. And it is a vital part of the human development because being able to choose one's identity without losing the respect of others or being excluded is the hallmark of an inclusive society. So, there is a need for managing diversity. And therefore, the report suggests that valuing cultural diversity or valuing cultural liberty is a way to respond to new claims of countries, communities and individuals. These claims are political in nature. And we come to the Indian case. So, we have discussed about the major development in the global scenario that all happened in 1998, 2001 and 2004. But in India, unity in diversity is a political imagination and central principle for the creation or development of a nation state. India emerged as a nation state by uniting diverse cultures, diverse languages, and diverse people. Therefore, Constitution of India is not a politico-administrative document. It is a document that provides a new value system to live and work in a newly emerged country, which is based on the democratic principle. So, therefore, this Constitution strongly supports the constitutional morality has been put on top of social morality, because in an Indian context, social morality is influenced by many customs and traditions that are not inclusive and many times very discriminatory. Therefore, for a new nation state, we need new values, new social values, new political values, new ways of life. The Constitution was a document for providing those ideals, those values for an emerging society. For example, the idea of a secularism. Indian Constitution recognizes and respects all religion. However, we are not a religious country. In similar fashion, we can see that the state have been created on the basis of language. It's a linguistic state. However, we do not have a national language. However, we have 22 recognized languages in the 8th schedule of the Constitution. So, this is another way of respecting diversity and diversity in languages. So, in that sense, one can convincingly say that diversity as a value of inclusion is ingrained in the Constitution of India, and it has happened long before the European or global discussion and debate started on issues of diversity. Summary: post-60s, the 60s or 70s, the diversity concerns emerged in Europe and North America. And this scenario has linked to socio-demographic changes that had been taking place at that time. And it has some economic rationale and the social rationale. And end of the 20th century or beginning of the 21st century witnessed a global recognition for value diversity. The transnational agencies like UNDP, UNESCO, all these groups have made a substantial contribution for this. And interestingly, the cultural diversity is increasingly seen as a catalyst for development. It is a very important development in the history of the development itself. And however, Indian freedom movements, which started in the early 20th century, actually followed the ideas of the diversity in mobilizing people, and it has culminated in the form of a constitution which values diversity like any other document, socio-political or political administrative document in the world. Thank you.